What is up, guys? It's another beast here. I just scared you right there. Today's gonna be another scary reaction video. This is the animated videos, but I don't really want to do this one. Because I'm going down to Lubbock this Friday. I don't want to promise you, but I want to vlog. I think it's for 3 days. So what am I sitting like a girl? So yeah, I think it's for like from Friday to Sunday. And it's for my mom's side of the family reunion, and I just want to go, and I might go for each year, probably not, I don't care, I don't know, yeah, but I just want, this is 4 minutes long, and it's called The Motel, and I'm going to be sleeping in the motel, a motel, and I don't want to think about this each time I try to go to sleep, but I'm going to have to. So. My brother's like, why aren't you putting the videos in it? I'm like, I don't really want to put videos on my YouTube channel that's not mine. But go subscribe to Llama Arts. That's the scary animations I've been looking at. So yeah, let's hit it. Let's exit. Wait one second. I'm gonna have to turn up the volume.
Blew.
Okay. So, let's try it again. Let's exit. If you can hear it, it doesn't.
I was 19 years old at the time, working at a sketchy motel. The motel was pretty run down, and the majority of people who stayed there were locals that were just doing things they weren't supposed to be doing.
Ching chong.
Let's just say the cops came by multiple times a week.
Just shut someone.
I worked as both a front desk person, checking in these creeps all hours of the night,
oh, it's a girl,
and as a housekeeper who got to clean up their nasty, vomit-smelling rooms afterwards. One afternoon,
vomit.
I was working as a housekeeper in the second building of the motel, on the backside furthest from the office. I hated working over there because it not only had the most worn-down rooms, but it was always pretty vacant over there.
Probably
way too quiet
in Lubbock.
I began cleaning one of my last rooms and wanted to get done in a hurry because it was getting late. I was washing the mirror in the room that I was cleaning when all of a sudden, I saw a man in the reflection staring at me. He was mid-50s, dirty, with long,
how you doing,
greasy
girl?
Hair. Startled, I screamed, oh my god. I told him he scared me. The room I was currently cleaning was vacant, so there was no reason why this man should have been in there watching me clean. However, we just had a meeting on customer satisfaction, and my boss was really pressuring us to be more polite and help the guests any way we could. Sir? I asked him cautiously. Can I get you anything? Towels? The man just stared back at me with a crooked
like
grin and
sweet
held out his hands to me. I thought maybe he was handing me a tip for cleaning his room earlier, but when I looked down, I saw he was holding a $100 bill.
Oh.
Alarm started going off in my head. No one tips $100 on a $40 a night room. The man just smiled and said his name was Terry. He said he was staying in the room next door with his wife Sherry and sort of joked about their names rhyming. He smelled like car oil and alcohol. When I asked him why he was trying to hand me $100, he laughed deep in his throat and said, me and my wife were watching you, and we just wanted to have fun with you. I felt like my heart jumped into my throat.
Let's get it off.
No, I can't do that, sir, I'm sorry. I wanted to run out of the room screaming, but he was blocking the door, my only exit. The man smiled again, taking on a softer tone of voice, and invited me to come into his room to meet his wife, just to talk as friends. I nervously told him no again, and that I had a lot of work to do for the day. I prayed to God he would just go away, and eventually he did. He grunted and walked off in what I assumed to be the direction of his room. My mind began racing. There is no wife, I thought. This man could try and kidnap me. I was 110 pounds at the time and not very strong. He could easily overpower me. I locked the room from the inside and went directly to the phone to call my manager at the front desk, but the phone wasn't working. Adrenaline began pumping through my veins, and despite what I was always told not to do, I was panicking. Did he cut the line? No, I thought. This is a crappy motel. It happens all the time. But I just have to get out. I remembered that I had my cell phone out on my housekeeping card, but that was outside the locked door. I'd have
just
to open
keep it
the
in
door
your
again.
Pocket. Why?
I cautiously opened the door to the room that I was cleaning and peered
236?
Out. I didn't see anyone, so I frantically began searching my cart for my cell phone.
He took it.
I was wasting too much time looking for it, so I just decided to run as fast as I could and make a break for the front desk in the office. Then from behind me, I heard the man again, but this time he was screaming to someone else, "She's running, she's getting away." I could hear his shoes slamming against the pavement after me. I quickly turned the corner, grabbed my key card, and let myself into a stock room and locked the door. Within moments, I heard the sound of the dirty guy and someone else running outside, searching for me. I stayed in that stockroom for 30 minutes, shaking, until I could no longer hear him searching for me. I finally got the courage to run the rest of the way to the front desk. When I made it there, I collapsed into my boss's arms and he called the police. The man and whoever else was in the room with him peeled out before the cops could arrive, and I was beyond shaken up. According to the police who ran a search, this wasn't the first time he had done something like this, and he was actually wanted for sexual assault,
gross
sexual imposition, and in the past was once charged with rape.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. He's probably
a few
racist.
Weeks later, on what happened to be my birthday, this guy was caught. A few weeks after that, I quit. I will never again work at another motel.
Okay, that wasn't that scary because I'm gonna be with my family and I ain't gonna run into any creeps. Probably I'm not. Probably I will. You never know. Creepy people out there. So yes, Friday I'm gonna be packing up my bag. Probably actually Thursday I'm gonna pack. Wednesday, I don't know. I'm probably gonna be packing up my bags and I'm gonna head out down to Lubbock, Texas. So my fans out there from Lubbock, Texas. Yeah. I'm gonna show you guys the Buddy Holly Center. Fun fact, my grandma dated Buddy Holly's drummer, and she knew Buddy Holly as a really good friend. Yeah. So yeah, go check out Llama Arts. Subscribe to him, he's actually pretty good. Animator. Yeah, so stick with me through Lubbock. Hopefully I film, hopefully and I don't know, I'm messing with it. Yeah. I try to. I'm 95% sure I might film. 80% sure I might film. 75% sure I might film. There we go. 75% sure I might film. I'm probably gonna film, but not a lot. Like, I might do, like, mini vlogs that last, like, 5 minutes. And if you put them all together, which I might do in the future, it's, it'd be, like, vlogs. Because I won't have my tablet on me at the time, and I won't be able to edit the vlogs. So, yeah. Post down up in the comments, anyone, Joseph, if you're watching, post up down in the comments what I should react to. It can be a music video, it can be anything. So yeah, go subscribe to Llama Arts, and yeah, and subscribe to me, like always, subscribe, like, and I'll see you in my next video. Strobe light time.